Hi, in the previous videos, we have got the basic overview of Pythons like conditional statements, loop statements, and loop control statements. We have also got the basic overview of built-in data structure available in Python, and in this video, we are going to focus on commonly used data structures, which is the list. You may find it very similar to the array or ArrayList from other programming languages, but it has its own differences and benefits. So the first thing is, in array or ArrayList, we can store only homogeneous elements and there is bound on size. But here in list, we can store heterogeneous elements and there is no bound on size. So you won't be getting any Stack Overflow exceptions here. So how to create a list? We use the square brackets. I've already told you in video number 6. You can go through that. We can verify the type. So type of A is list. The next thing is, like, let's try to store some elements in that. Here you can see that there is no error and we can store heterogeneous elements. If you'll not note it, the elements are retrieved in the same sequence we have stored it. It means the list is an ordered sequence. And if you want to access the elements of the list, we can utilize the concept of index. So let's say A of 0, then it will return the first index Ravi. Always remember that the indexing starts from 0 and it goes to n-1, where n is the length of that object. The next concept is new table. I have already created a video on how a string is immutable. You can go through that for better understanding. We have a method called id to verify where that object is stored. So if we'll say something like id of A, then it is getting stored at 696 location. Now let's try to append anything inside that list. Okay, now if you'll say A, then that is being added. We will learn more about how, what are the different methods available in the list. If you'll see, it has the same memory location still. So even if we change the value inside the list, it is having the same memory locations. It means the list is mutable. Now let's talk about the commonly used ADT or the operations on the list. Okay, so the first thing is return an element from the list at given position. It means we have to retrieve an element at a specific index, right? So we have square bracket for it. For example, A of 0, then it will say Ravi. A of 1, then it will say 12. But internally, this square bracket uses one dunder methods called getItem. So we will say a dot underscore underscore getItem underscore underscore, and we have to provide the index, something like 1. So you can say that 12. We will learn more about the what is the dunder method and all those in the upcoming videos. So the next thing is how to insert an element at a given position. We already know the concept of append. Append is something like a dot append. It takes one argument, which is object, and it add that object at the end of the list. For example, let's say I want to add over here Solanki at the end of the list. So, and if we'll say that Solanki is being added. But if we want to add or insert any position at a given index, then we have to utilize the concept of, or method of insert. So the first, it takes two arguments. The first one is the index position. So let's say I want to Kumar at position number 1. And if we say A, then you can see that Kumar is being added to position 1. Now let's append one duplicate value inside that. So A dot append 12. Okay. So if you say A, you can find out 12 is being added twice, right? Now, if we want to remove the first occurrence of an element, so we have the remove method. So a dot remove, and it takes first argument as value, and it will go and delete the first argument. So you can see that here the 12 is still here, but the first occurrence is being deleted. Now let's try to append the same 12 at index number 2. So now we have 12 here and here, right? But we want to delete this 12, not this one. So we can say that we have the del method. So, since in Python everything an object, so if we want to delete any object, we can utilize the del object. So we can simply say A of the last element is -1, Okay, so and if we say yes, the element has been deleted. Since Python list is mutable, so we can replace the value, say something like okay. And if we say, you can see that Kumar is being replaced with Solanki. Now consider a scenario where you want to find out how many elements in the list. We have different ways to do it. The first one is, in Python we have the len method, so we can say that len of a, then it will say return 6. But similarly, we have the render method called len, a dot underscore underscore len, so it will also return the same element. There are other operations. So if you want to find out the maximum element, we have the max method, so max of b, so it is saying, and similarly we have some min method. And if you want to find out how many times a specific element has been occurred, we can find out using the count method. For example, b dot count 13, so it has been occurred once, and if we say 55, then it has been two times. In this way, we can have play around a list and do the operations.